The following is a presentation of Santa Monica College.
From the campus of Santa Monica College here in Santa Monica, California, Horsair basketball is on the air. Where tonight, the Horsairs come home, playing for their first win in Western State Conference play against the Citrus College Owls. And hello and welcome into the booth. My name is James Powell. We're here just above the southern sidelines. I'm with Claudius West. And Claudius, Horsairs have had a rough go of it so far this season. They're under 500. They're winless in conference play. And they've lost three other players to injury. But no matter the situation, any team can pull through if they can hit their free throws. And unfortunately, the Horsairs have been wildly inconsistent so far.
Absolutely. The thing about the Santa Monica Corsairs is that we are making a lot of points in the paint. And we cannot, according to the stats, definitely judging from the last four or five games, count on any real money from the three-point line. And so that means we're scoring a lot of points in the low post, in the paint. That means a lot of people will be going to the lines this game. Those shooters must make those shots. That is the only way this game is even going to be close.
Especially since free throws are A, their fundamentals, and B, they're free points.
Basic fundamentals, but James, that then goes back to the inexperience that we have on this team with a lot of no real returning sophomores except for one or two, and most being freshmen still probably learning the system, but they're definitely going to have to step up here today at the line.
And for more on one of the most important returning freshmen, we go down to the third member of our team, Jose Barajas.
Thanks, guys. After the departures of Anise Palomore and Bria Nelson, Oshila Gray has inherited the leadership role on this team as one of only two returning sophomores this season. Gray is on pace to nearly double her totals in both points per game with 17 and steals per game with 2 this season. The Corsairs, they're in the midst of their second three-game losing streak and will lean heavily on Gray if they wish to end this slump. Back when the SMC Corsairs beat Butte College to end their first three-game losing streak, the Corsairs had 3 players in double figures, with Gray leading the way with 28 points. Now the gentleman calling the game from the best seat in the house, here's James and Claudius.
And now as we see the, I believe we will begin with the Citrus starting lineups. At the guard, Janae Chamois, a 5'7 sophomore guard from Mira Loma, California. At the other guard, Elise Mejia, a 5'3 sophomore guard from Garfield High School in Los Angeles, California. At the forward, Marisol Chavez Delgado, a freshman forward, 5'9. And at the other a third forward, a sophomore forward, Alison Zaylin from Glendale, California. And on the starting line for the Horsairs, at the guard, number 4, Oshela Doria, 5'6 sophomore from Hamilton High School. At the other guard, Caitlin Flores, a 5'5 freshman from Boulder City, Nevada. At the forwards, we have Hayata Eves, a 5'6 freshman from West Covina and Walnut High School. At the other forward, Roberta Hayes, the other returning sophomore, a 5'9 sophomore from Newcastle, Australia. And at the center, Mamusu Seka, a 6'2 freshman from Stockholm, Sweden.
Seka is going to be very important in this game because she is going to be that person that they get the ball to under the rim each and every time that they have a chance to. She's going to need to make every shot of this game if they hope to be successful in beating the Owls here, Jim.
Our referee crew tonight, Brian Woods, is the gentleman with the hair. It appears he will be on our left. Brian Woods is the gentleman, the bald gentleman, coming towards us here in the shot. Zipporah Chase will be the one responsible for throwing us up to get us started here. And Dana Page is the one gentleman talking at the scorer's table. It appears the Horsairs will defend from our left to our right. Citrus going the other way. Citrus in the blue and orange. Santa Monica in the gray and blue. Any final thoughts before we get this going here, Claudius?
Make the layups. Make the easy baskets. Do not allow for the Owls to get too much momentum because they too struggle from the three line, which means they're going to be driving the lane too. So we're going to have to defend down low, score down low on the other end of the ball.
All right. Now the new rules for this year and going forward, the women's game will play 4 10-minute quarters with a halftime break. And it looks like it's just about showtime here. Ball's up. Santa wins it back. Citrus will have the possession arrow. O'Sheila has it now and will control it. Almost lost it. Etevez looks for her person. Drives. Etevez still has it. Throws it up. Good. 2-0 Corsairs.
Good shot by Kayla Chavez. They're going to have to continue to make those shots. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Every single time.
The offense, but O'Sheila gets her first steal of the night. Drives it down. Throws it up. And it's good. 4-0 Corsairs.
Good offense, good defense on the part of the Corsairs there. Great play.
Gutierrez will bring it at Horas and will marshal the offense. Tries to get into Zaylin, but it's tipped out. Citrus ball.
Good hustle by Seca, though. Great hustle by number 12 there. She's pressing them hard. She drew a foul, but she pressed them. And that's what we need to do.
Chamois throws it inside to Delgado. Delgado out to Gutierrez. Gutierrez for three. Good. First score for the Owls. 4-3 Corsairs. O'Shale will bring it across the timeline. Calls out the play. Works the yo-yo at the volleyball stripe. Gives it to Etevez. Etevez dribbles, drives, pulls up, and looks for an option. Gets it to Hayes. Hayes gets it on the other side to Gray. Gray gets bumped off the ball. Gray looks, drives, stops up, and falls and loses the ball, but recovers it. One, and that will be a shot clock violation on the Corsairs.
I think the Owls did a very good job right there of keeping the Corsairs out at the arc. They drove through the lane. They tried to a couple of times, James, and it just the Owls were not having it.
Mejia will start the offense on this trip down. Drives. Finds nothing but Corsair defense and throws it away, but she draws a foul on the inside. First foul call of the game goes to the Corsairs.
Again, I like the aggressiveness on the part of the Corsairs on defense because we have to at least attempt to stop those easy scores because that's how the Owls have been winning, same as Santa Monica.
Mejia has two shots, 8:28 left in the first period. I'm James Powell with Claudius West as well as Jose Barajas on the sideline. Thank you for joining us. It's now 4-4 Corsairs after the first made free throw. And Gray will go out and let's see who's coming in. That will be Mejia Chandler, a 5'6 freshman guard from Minneapolis, Minnesota in Hopkins High School. Excuse me, they changed that at the end. Oh. And also, Caitlin Flores, no, she stays in. Only O'Shea Gray will go out. And now Mejia has the second of her two free throws. And it's no good. Rebound corralled by Flores. And now here is Momasutu, and Momasutu is fouled and will draw the first Corsair free throws. Oh no, it will go out on the side. She did draw the first Corsair foul. The foul goes on Gutierrez, her first of the game. Here's Flores. Flores drives around the screen from Musu, as she likes to be called. And it goes out of bounds, but out on a Owl touch.
I think it's going to be very important for the Corsairs to get the ball in here. To our center. Let's look for some easy points here.
Free throw from the far corner from Hayes is no good. Corralled by Flores. Flores goes up a second time, no good. And the Owls will have it. Zaylin has it, and it's a jump ball. Possession arrow goes to the Owls.
A couple of missed opportunities there from very close to the basket, but we did get up there and try to get the rebounds. We got our hands on it at least.
Possession arrow now goes to the Corsairs on the next jump ball. Mejia gets it to Chamois. Chamois from three. That's her second three-pointer of the game. 7-4. Owls now take the lead. Hayes will bring it. Flores will bring it down. Back to Flores. Flores looks for an option. Throws it to the far corner to Chandler. Chandler loses it out of bounds. Owls ball. Court's starting to tilt towards the Owls, isn't it now?
Definitely the momentum's turning, James. And it's, again, they're guarding the inside. They're making it very difficult. We're just not doing the best of making up offense from outside and on the perimeter here.
Mejia drives through an open lane, tries to get it inside, but Musu gets it and pushes it forward. Etevez brings it down. Etevez marshals the offense. Swings it to Chandler. Chandler gets it back to Etevez. Etevez at the top. Now to Hayes. Excuse me, to Flores. Flores on the inside. No good. Horse, the Owls will bring up the ball now. Gets it to the far side. To Gutierrez. Gutierrez brings it back out to Mejia. Mejia works around the screen. Goes nowhere with it, though. Almost gets the ball stripped from her. Drives inside. Layup. It's blocked by Musu.
Lots of aggressiveness on the part of the Corsairs on that play.
Etevez on the break. Layup up. No good off the front of the rim. An easy basket given away. Now Chamois brings it up. Back and forth we go. She gives it to Delgado. Delgado misses it. Throws it out. Gets it to
Again.
Gutierrez. Gutierrez to the far side. 15's up. And no good. The rebound to Owls. Who put it back in?
Again, yes, the Owls just scored, but Seca has been doing a pretty good job from inside the key, blocking shots, making for easy scores to be very difficult for the Owls to get.
9-4 Owls now. Musu on the inside, drives, has an open lane up, but it goes off the front of the rim. Rebound to the Horsairs, and Hayes draws the foul. The first shooting foul of the evening for the Horsairs, and as we saw, free throw shooting for the Horsairs is big.
It's going to be paramount in this game. And because we go in so much, we attack that rim, that's going to be definitely be the game plan. And also maybe an up-tempo offense to kind of throw the Owls off. We're going to the line a lot in this game if the strategy works as planned. And it's a good thing that we just made that shot. We got to continue doing that all night.
Hayes hits the first one. O'Shea LeGrate comes back in for the Horsairs. Zaylin goes out for the Owls. And Joy Aldo will come in for her. A 5'7 freshman guard from Hacienda Heights. As Hayes hits the second of two, Owls will look to push the ball. Villaruz, who also came in for Mejia. And now it's Gutierrez goes up, gets it out. Villaruz comes back, out for three. Good.
The Owls are unusually hot from the three today, and I think we may have to change up our game plan a bit if this continues to come up with a better perimeter defense.
12-6 Owls off of the Joy Aldo three-pointer. Etevez fights on the perimeter. She tries to get to the inside, goes nowhere, loses the ball, but draws the foul. And that foul is a on-the-floor foul that will go against Janae Chamois. Flores will bring it in. From the baseline. She looks for, throws it all the way out, and it's nearly stolen away from Gray. Gray drives on the scramble, gets it out to Musu. Musu's three-pointer is good. 12-8 Horsairs. They rule it a two-pointer.
Seca is really doing her job on both sides of the court today. She's blocking shots, she's playing great defense, and she just also made that last two-point play for the Corsairs as well.
And
definitely an asset.
And Seca just picked up her first block of the evening, sending it out of bounds on the western end line. Villaruz will bring it in. Guarded by Gray. She throws it out far for Chamois. Chamois corrals it at the volleyball line. She looks to drive against Hayes. She gives it up to Marissa Brown. Gets it to Villaruz. Villaruz drives, turns around for Brown, and it's good. 14-8 Horsairs, or 14-8 Owls lead, Horsairs down by six.
Coach is on her feet after that play.
Etevez will get the ball from Gray, gives it back to Gray. Gray gives it to Hayes on the far side. Hayes looks to get it on the inside, doesn't find anyone. Then marshals it back out to the top, gives it to Etevez on the bend. Back to Hayes. Looks to drive in, gets it to O'Shea on the pick. About to set her, set and drives, and it's home for the travel.
Once again, the Owls doing a great job of creating traffic jams in the lanes, creating traffic jams under the rim. They are not making the shooting easy for us, James.
Santa Monica calls its first time out. They have four remaining for the game.
The coach has spent the last few plays on her feet and very, very excited about the last few plays and her team's gameplay. And maybe she's called the timeout so that they can make some game plan changes.
Now, obviously, we've seen the Santa Monica Horsairs try to go inside, but they have not found success. We did get set on one basket already, but that actually came from the three-point line.
Mm-hmm.
What do you see from the Citrus defense?
I see them guarding the inside. I don't think they believe the Corsairs can shoot from the outside. I've seen a lot of traffic right in the middle, down low. They're preventing the Corsairs from making those easy layups, easy three-point shots. And so far, it seems to be working. They're up 14-8.
Valarouz will bring it in off the timeout. She gives it to Gutierrez. Gutierrez looks, gets it to Aldo. Aldo from three again off the front of the rim. First missed shot of the evening. Oshela will lead the break. She has Seta and Eves. She misses Seta but puts it up herself, and it falls. 14-10, Owl.
Great fast break, 2 points by Oshela Gray. Like I said earlier, she's going to have to do that all game long. Draw the fouls, make the easy layups. That's the Corsairs' key to victory here.
Villarouz will get it with 20 on the shot clock. She drives against Gray, gets the double team. Hits it out to Gutierrez. Gutierrez for three off the bat of the rim. Gray will take it out now. Across the timeline, she only has Gutierrez to beat. Goes up and draws the foul.
Again, that Corsair game plan. Fast breaks, easy points. You keep that tempo up, I think it throws off the Owls. And the added bonus is Oshela Gray will go to the line where she's 71% shooting this season.
Now we know she's sick. She must be not. This must be the time when it doesn't feel good because she has to stop and think. Her first one's up, and it's good.
She actually does have a look as if though she's just a bit exhausted here, but she's playing through it nonetheless.
Yes, she is.
That's what makes a great leader, I suppose, Jane.
Hiona Evan comes in for Roberta Hayes. Get Hayes her first rest of the evening. Sheila's second shot is up and through. Tiffany Villarouz will lead the Owl attack across the timeline. They're looking on the outside. They get a pick for Villarouz. She drives in, throws it to Brown. Brown gets it blocked, but Villarouz recovers. Brown again, and in. Again, the Corsairs let it go fast. Baseball pass over the head of everyone intended for Setha. Owl's ball.
Normally, the fast pace is a good idea for the Corsairs. Just a little more control on the throws, though.
Mihaela Chandler will come in again for Gray, trying to save her legs as much as possible. Owls lead by four at this juncture with 3:25 left to go in the first quarter. And there seems to be a moment.
We've scored a quick 4 points here. Both of those points came on fast break plays. We're going to look to see a whole lot more of that this game, James. The Owls, however, have really made it a point to shoot from outside, and so far it's been working for them. And it may possibly also now be opening up the lanes inside, as they've scored now twice fairly easily from around the paint.
Yeah, speed appears to be the weakness of the Owls tonight, and let's see if the Corsairs can attack that. Villarouz has the ball to start here, gets the pick, but goes nowhere with it. Throws it over to Aldo. Aldo again for three. Good. She's 3 for 4 on the night so far.
Another easy 3 points. Again, the Corsairs are not really defending well from the perimeter.
Set from the outside, no good. Eves fights for the ball and wins it clean. Avoids the jump. Eves now restarts. 25 on the shot clock. That's Flores to Chandler. Chandler almost loses the ball, but loses it in a safe spot. And Evans calling for her on the inside. And Chandler's pass goes right past her. Flores tries to get the ball back, but to no avail. That's Chamois driving in. Gets it rejected. Eves will turn it the other way.
There we
go. Back and forth we go. Eves all the way. Pulls up. No good off the front of the rim. Villarouz goes the other way. Again we go. And she will slow it down as much as they can now. That's Chamois. Chamois drives the baseline. Draws the foul on the floor. The foul will go on Flores. That's the Corsairs' second team foul. Flores' first of the night. Chamois to the line for two. The first one is good. More substitutions now. Flores will go out. And Robin Ashkenazi, it's a little bit of a tongue twister, Ashkenazi will come in. Hope your folks are enjoying it so far. 2012, the Horsairs trail by 8 to the Owls, and now Efes will come up. Efes looks, gives it to Evans. Evans to Efes. Gets it into the corner to Chandler. Chandler drives to the free throw line, gets it to Seta. Seta drives, and is hauled for the travel.
And I believe that is the second travel on Seta this evening. Again, she's doing very well on both sides of the ball, under the rim, rebounding, blocks, things of that nature. Good defense, but she has to keep the ball in hand.
The ball is golden. Hold on to the ball.
There you
Chamois
go.
Works it now. Gets it to Villarouz. Villarouz, up. No good. Set with another rebound. Gets it to Chandler, who pushes it to Evans. Evans drives, hits it out to Ashkenazi. No good.
I actually think that pass to Robin Ashkenazi could have been a little faster. She had an opportunity to do it on the fast break. Held on a little bit too long, I think. And I think that threw off Ashkenazi when she took the jumper. But you still have to make those shots. It's a very easy shot. She's 6 foot two. She has a nice size height advantage over everyone else on the floor.
And as we saw, as you saw there, folks, solid Horsair defense leads to a turnover. Horsair ball. And Coach Lydia Strong calling for a slowdown, at least for the moment. Chandler works the yo-yo at the volleyball stripe. Crosses over. Finds no one, gets it to Seta on the outside. Seta for three, no good off the bat of the rim. Hafe dives for it. The Owls have an open lane. That's Brown. Brown goes up, and it's good.
I respect the hustle on the part of Seta here. Yes, she drew the foul, but I'd rather you draw the foul, at least this early in the game, than to allow for easy plays that makes the momentum shift over to the Citrus side of the ball. Make them score from the free throw line.
22-12 Owls with a free throw up coming for Brown. Brown is a freshman from Montclair, California, Bishop Amat High School. And her free throw is good. 23-12 for Owls now. And we will send it back the other way. Chandler holds the play. Gets the screen from Evans. Gives it to Seta. Seta in the corner. Tries to drive it middle. Tries to get a pick from Evans again. To Ashkenazi. Ashkenazi to Hayes. Excuse me, that's Evans.
And
but either way, it's a missed shot.
Missed shot, missed rebound. We have no less than 2 6-foot and over players on the court right now. We need to do a better job of defending and grabbing those offensive rebounds.
And Evans on the absolutely free breakout gets the two. You have to invert those. They must get the easy ones. And now this Owls drive in and draw a foul. Chamois draws the foul. And let's see what that's going on. Brianna Evans. Evans gets the foul. It will be an inbounding foul. Shot clock's turned off. Villarouz gets it around the pit. She's in the corner. She drives the baseline. Throws it out. Almost taken away. And they will reset. They are definitely taking the final shot. Chamois. To Aldo. Aldo for three is an air ball. But Owls recover seven on the clock, and it's good. Clock keeps running. Three, two, one, and that is the first quarter. And we'll be right back on the other side of this break with the second quarter.
I'm going to need another quarter to get into rhythm, so just bear with me.
And we're back here with the second quarter, 25-14 Owls lead. We get the ball inside. It'll be Chandler, Evans, Ashkenazi, and Seha with Eves on the floor for the Horseras. They get it to Chandler. Chandler tries to drive on the inside, but loses it. And the Owls don't take care of it, but they get the ball back off of a Horsera touch. For the Owls on the floor, it's Meza, Mejia, Delgado, and Gutierrez.
I think that what we're seeing here definitely is a lack of experience on the side of, on the part of the Corsairs. This is where that difference between freshman year and sophomore year is glaring.
Gutierrez looks for the inside and throws it to no one. She was looking for Delgado, but Delgado does save it. And the Owls retain possession, 14 on the shot clock. They get it into Delgado this time. Draws the double team on the inside. And it's one around to Gutierrez. Gutierrez for three, no. But Delgado picks it up and gets the rebound too.
We allowed a second point opportunity that that is definitely contributing to the disparity in score right now. Again, we have the height advantage under the boards. We need to grab more of them on both sides of the ball.
Chandler will marshal the offense. Tries to get to Ashkenazi. Ashkenazi puts it up, but draws the foul. It's the first foul on the Owls this quarter. Fouls reset on the Hoarders.
Foul number 34, Allison Zollin.
And Allison Zollin will draw the first foul. Her first foul for the Owls.
At 14-27, we're definitely going to need both shots. And we're going to need to try to get to the line as many more times as possible if we expect to come back into this game.
Ashkenazi hits the first. This is her second. Off the front of the rim. But Evans gets it, puts it up, and draws another foul. This is another trip to the line.
Very nice rebound and foul draw on the part of Evans. Evans, I believe, is on the line twice. Again, she's going to need to drive more. She's going to need to grab more boards. They're going to touch her more this game.
Evans' first shot is up, and it's no good. And here comes that thing that we talked about in the open here.
Those free throws.
Easy opportunities. You need to convert those if you want to win. Evans' second shot now. Is good. 1-for-2 from this trip. Ashkenazi looks like she needed a little help getting up. Looks like she's fine, though. Meza throws it up from three from the corner. That is good.
Amazing shot. Amazing shot by Meza.
36-16, Owls.
Again, the Owls are not normally the greatest from the three-point line, but against the Corsairs today, they have been pretty hot on the perimeter.
Seha drives the lane, goes up, and it's no good. An easy opportunity goes away again for the Corsairs.
Corsairs getting last touch on that ball, but at least they got a touch on the ball. I would prefer that to just allowing the other team to grab it and pull it down each and every time we go to the basket.
Mejia will start the offense this trip down, gets a screen, drives a pretty easy lane, goes up, and it's blocked. That's Ashkenazi on the block.
Easy lane.
Here comes Chandler. Chandler stops at the half-court line and slows it down. Ashkenazi looks for someone on the inside. Chandler looks for someone on the inside. She gives it to Gray, who swings it around to Evans. Evans goes up, a miracle shot that doesn't get answered.
Delgado on the side, on the Citrus side, did a very good job of defending and has now grabbed a rebound.
Swung to Meza. Meza is short, but the Owls recover for an easy opportunity, but no, they cannot convert.
Delgado was very energetic on those last two plays. Both sides of the floor, she grabbed one rebound on both sides of the court. She defended well.
Sethu.
The Corsairs may need to keep an eye out for her as the game continues.
Sethu will go out, as well as Chandler. Efez and Flores in for them, respectively. Gray will bring it down. And man, you can see the wearer that the flu has taken on her so far tonight. But she fights valiantly, gets it crossover, and the pick from Hayes pulls up, and it's good. 30-18, Owls.
Good hustle on the part of O'Shea Gray. Pushing through the injuries to remain an asset to her team.
The Owl pass attempt on the break goes nowhere. Horsair ball. Gray will bring it down. And the Horsairs have seemed to slow the offense. No fast pace again. Hayes breaks around in the near corner. Excuse me, Flores with a reverse shot, no good. And here come the Owls. Delgado brings it down. Has Flores on the wing, excuse me, has Gutierrez on the wing, gets it to Meza. Meza to Villarruz. Villarruz gets the deuce.
The Owls are shooting from the three-point line and scoring almost at will from the perimeter.
That was scored as a three. It's now 33-18. And Gray looks to start him back, gets a pick from Evans, gets it back to Evans on the inside, and it's good. 33-8, 33-20, Corsairs. And here come the Owls. Again, slowing the pace from what we saw in the first quarter. Mejia gets it to the corner to Gutierrez. Gutierrez works, finds Mejia. Delgado gets the foul on the inside. That will be the first team foul on the Corsairs.
I think that was a good bit of defense there, however, because Delgado's definitely a threat, and you do not want her shooting that close to the rim. I can live with that foul.
Wholesale changes coming here for the Corsairs. Evans goes out, and Eshkenazi goes out. Sethu comes back in, and Hayes comes back in. Hayes works on the, Sethu gets the ball and will push it on the offense to Gray. Gray drives, stops. Gets the pick from Sethu, gives it to Flores. Flores back to Gray. Etevez comes around the bend, gets the ball. Etevez gets it out to Flores and will draw a floor foul on the Owls.
The Corsairs didn't win on the fast break there, but this good foul here will give them a chance to score again, hopefully from the inside where they're strongest.
Flores will inbound from the northern sideline. Gets it into Gray at the corner. Looks for Seta on the inside. And Seta again gets called for traveling. That's her third on the night.
It's important to remember that Seta is a freshman, and she's done very well in this game. It's been travels and it's been loose balls on her part. So a little more ball control, more thoughtfulness with the ball, and I think we can actually get some more production out of her.
Delgado turns around, jumper, good. 35-20, Owls.
The Corsairs have had a pretty hard time defending against Delgado this game.
Gray will bring it up, crosses over and stops, and waits for the offense to set up. Etevez will come around the screen on the far side. Gray doesn't take it, gets it to Flores here on the near side. Shot is up, no good. Owls recover. That is Meza on the rebound, but the Corsairs steal it back. Etevez fights, puts it up, no good. Second rebound, will draw a foul on the Corsairs. It will go on Etevez off the rebound.
Good hustle by number 24, Caitlin Flores. Really taking the time to protect the ball, fighting for the ball. We definitely need more of that in this game.
Chamois will start. She works the yo-yo against Etevez, drives against her, gives it to Meza. Meza gets it to Adlau. Inside it goes to Brown. Brown puts it up and good. And the Corsairs will call a timeout.
Coach is not happy at the moment. And she saw it coming.
Now, what do you think she saw coming that she's so mad about?
Well, they're driving. They're driving the lanes at will. We have three very tall people on the floor right now, and yet we can't stop layups, and we're not stopping three-point shots either. We have to fix one of these, and with three bigs on the floor, we should be stopping the lane slices and the easy layups.
And, you know, Coach Strong's been doing this for a long time, and this is one of her younger teams she's ever had, and this must be a teaching moment. Even though she's down 17, it's still not yet halftime, but she's down 17. What can she tell her people on the floor now that will help them not only in this game but going forward?
Well, she can tell them to – I think awareness has been a big issue here. We've seen a few plays now where people were coming into the house. No one's home in the key. No one's paying attention. Missed block opportunities on one side of the floor. And on the other side of the floor, we're not doing a good enough job of fighting for those rebounds coming off of the missed shots that we are throwing up plenty of in this game. when you have low shooting percentages, it makes defense, defending your rim, and also defending on the other side very important. And we're struggling to do that today. But I think it's an awareness issue. Even with number five, number 12, Seca, holding on to the ball, being more aware of the rock. We've probably missed two or three good shots just based on that. That's travels right. And loose balls.
4 minutes and 40 seconds left on the clock here in the second quarter. Flores gets it to Seca, who loses it again right on Hugh. That'll go out of bounds, and the officials call it for Citrus. It's another lost ball from Seca.
Another lost ball, but there was some defense that time, you know. Chamois on the part of the Owls was right there to put a hand out.
All right, and speaking of the devil, there she is, Chamois here. Has been marshaling as the lead guard for the Owls, gets it to Meza. Meza tries to get it on the inside to Delgado. Delgado goes up and draws the foul.
I'm not sure I would have called that.
The officials have been calling it tight. Again, it's the officiating crew is Brian Woods, Dana Page, and Sephora Chase. Here's Delgado. Her first shot is good. It's not good. It bounced off of every part of the rim and fell to the floor.
Nonetheless, Mamusa Seca was under the rim, defending well. Again, I can take that foul. I can live with that.
Delgado's second shot is good. Gray again will start the offense. This time they're moving a little faster. Now Gray stops and hauls out the play. She gets it to the far side to Flores, into Seca. Seca tries to get it to someone, bounces off a couple of hands. This time Hayes tries to put it up, but it's no good. Owls come the other way. Delgado pushes off Gray and gets the foul.
Again, no one was there for the pull down on the offensive side. We're going to need second chance opportunities. We're missing too many shots, and so it's going to be important that the Corsair players protect the rim better.
Delgado goes to the line again, hits the first, 39-20 Owls now. The foul was the fourth team foul. Owls are not in the bonus, but will be on the next foul. Delgado's second shot is off the front of the rim and is pulled down by Ashkani. Gray will push it forward. She does not have numbers, stops at the top of the arc, and waits. The offense is setting up. Gray holds out the play again. Gray drives against Chamois. It's up, and it's no good, but she draws the foul.
That's the game plan at work. Gray is going to be attacking that rim as often as she has a chance to. And again, she's 71% from the line. If you want anybody to have the rocket in their hands when that referee's fist comes out, you want it to be O'Shea and Gray.
That's true. And evidenced by as she missed the first one. Now here is her second.
And then it's also important to note that free throw percentage and making those shots from the line is going to be important on the side of the part of the Owls as well.
Gray makes the second. The Owls will bring it up. That's Chamois again. She took the foul against Gray. Gets it on the inside to Delgado. Puts it up and in against the physical defense of Ashkenazi.
Delgado has been very tough on the inside in the last few minutes of this game. I'm not surprised that she made the easy 2 points that was made there.
Seca drives the lane and is fouled. Corsairs are now in the double bonus. Seca will go to the line for 2. Owls have 5 team fouls on them this quarter. Seca's first is good.
She may be having trouble with the ball control, but she hasn't so far had a lot of trouble from the line.
Here's her second. She works quickly, and it's good. Sometimes when you're having a bad free throw performance, you need to speed it up a little just to gain rhythm. Adlau will bring it up now, taking it out of Chamois' hands for the first time in a while. Goes inside to Brown, but she does not receive it, but the Owls will hold on to the ball off of a Horsair tip.
Again, good hands right there by Mamusa Seca.
Meza will bring it in. On the western end line, gets it out to Adlau. Adlau to Meza on the corner, no good, and air ball over everything. But Brown recovers. Adlau again. Will pull up from three. No good. And the Horsairs recover this time.
And I'm not actually surprised that the Owls are missing from the line. They normally don't make three-point shots. That hasn't been their strongest suit. They're only 38% on the season. Gray. So I would make them shoot from the perimeter.
Gray works on Shamwa. Two guards going against each other. Into Ashkhani. Ashkhani drives. Baseline. Up. And good. Here on Citrus looking to push it on transition. Shamwa again. This time guarded by Flores. Shamwa drives in. Gets it to Adlau. Adlau loses her step. But seems to recover. Owls have the ball. Shamwa again. He starts it with 17 left on the shot clock. Shamwa drives the lane. Draws the double. Tries to throw it out. It's tipped. But Meza gives it in. Now Brown has it on the inside. No good. Set him with the rebound. Here comes Flores to Gray. Gray will push it. She does not have numbers, though. She looks to hit out to Evans. Evans gets it inside, but it's tipped. Intended for Ashkenazi, but tipped out. Could have been a number of Owls. They had that very well defended.
As did the Corsairs on the other side of the ball in this last play, James. We had two or three bodies right in the key. And both had hands up. Tipping the ball, grabbing the rebounds. Delgado.
Badgers comes in for the Owls for Brown. Owls take the ball away. There's Meza, gets it to Adlau. Adlau for three. 44-26, Owls lead. And now, go ahead.
Once again, it's been a huge three-point game for the Owls so far. And we don't have much in the way of answers for it because they're also slicing through the lanes very well.
Gray pulled up from the free throw line, and that was no good. But the Owls will take their first timeout. Now, it's working well for the Owls. Obviously, their three-point shooting is much higher. We don't have the stats in yet, but it's above, certainly above their season average. But that doesn't seem to be the only way they are taking apart this defense.
No, and that's the problem for the Corsairs in this game. They are unusually hot from the three-point line, and on top of that, they're driving the lane. So we're being forced to defend everywhere, and you can't be in all places at once, especially when they're proving to you that once you're on the perimeter, they can cut inside at will. So it's really going to fall on the Corsairs to figure out a way to stop the points in the paint, so that they're forced to shoot from the outside, because by the third or fourth quarter, they may be tired, and that three-point may fail.
That's true. And now here's Shamwa out of the timeout. Just a little over 1 minute left to go here in the quarter. At halftime, Jose Barajas will talk to Coach Strong. Shamwa drives on the inside, but goes nowhere with it. Hits it out to Adlau. Adlau from just inside the three. Good. Will they count that as a three? No. 46-26. Owls lead by 20, 1 minute left to go. They get it in the inside to Seha. Get it to Evans. Evans jumps. Three.
Two-pointer.
Looked like a three from here, but they counted it as two. The foot must have been on the line. 45 seconds left to go. Owls will hold. Looks like the Horsairs want a two-for-one if they can get a stop it here. Estepan gets it in. That's to Meza. Meza.
They have a defense set up here that is...
They get the jumper from Badgers. Badgers is good.
The Corsairs had a defense set up there that was meant to prevent the Owls from driving the lane, and instead they turned around and made it from the backcourt again.
Owls can hold for the last shot after the Gray miss. Shamwa, not saying will hold for the last shot. Pulls it out to the bottom of the Horsair flag here at Horsair Pavilion. Drives the line, gets the pick, but goes nowhere with it. Switches to set, gets it to Meza in the corner. 3 seconds left. No good. Rebound. Goes out of bounds as time expires. And that is the half. Wait. Now, Corsairs are down by 20 here. What do they need to go going forward?
They need to stop that three-point shot. Let's start there. You need to stop the three-point shots. But that's even going to be difficult to do because, as discussed a few minutes earlier, the Owls are also driving the lanes, and they're driving the lanes successfully. So we need more blocks. We need more defensive rebounds. And on the other side of the ball, we need to get under the rim and pull some of these missed shots down, get some second-chance opportunities. And then as the game progresses, force the Owls to put people like O'Shea LeGray, who has a great three-point percentage, onto the line.
All right. And now let's go down to the floor Jose Barajas. Jose?
Citrus is showing good movement with the ball and also shooting surprisingly well from the three-point. Any changes defensively going into the second half?
Yeah, you know, our closeouts aren't very good right now. You know, we're trying to contain it. They're number one player, number four, but everyone else is getting open shots. So instead of closing out and stopping early, we need to make those shooters dribblers and see what they can do. Our help side has to be better. Closeouts have to be better. Our rebounding has to be better. We have to be better.
Changes offensively going into the second half?
No, it's really just about execution. We're getting layups, so it's really just a lack of concentration. We just got to finish our layups and execute better. You know, I don't feel like they're running anything particularly great that's stopping us. It's really just us stopping ourselves right now.
And quick note, Oshayla's Gray's health going into the second half?
She's fine. She's a baller. She's ready.
Thank you very much, Coach.
All right, thank you.
And we're back here at Horsehair Pavilion. Halftime score, 48-28, Owls lead. Claudius, what do the Horsehairs need to do here in the second half? I know we started this at the end of halftime. But what else do they need to do?
Well, it's no different than What we have to do better is execute on offense, better, more rebounding offensively, less fast break missed points. And on defense, we need to be more aware of where the ball is on the floor and defend against the easy two-point opportunity.
Well, right off the jump, Chamois hits an easy three-pointer, 51-28 Horsehairs trail. Now here comes Seha. Seha misses it off the drive. And Citrus, they won't get a fast break, but they will move the ball up. Chamois hits around the first defender, pulls up, and it's blocked, but she draws the foul.
Second, I believe that's her third foul.
That is correct. That is her third foul.
So she's at a point where she's going to start getting in trouble here. She's going to have to ease up a bit on the defensive side of the ball. But again, I like the hustle. I like that she was there. You know.
Chamois has this first free throw. Second is the first Horsehair in foul trouble with her third personal. Chamois' first free throw of the half is off the bat of the rim. No changes here for either team. And Chamois will take her second. It's interesting her routine. She always touches her right foot, the bottom of her right foot.
A lot of pro athletes and have various superstitions and ways of going about the game. It's always interesting when you can find that.
Chamois hits her second, 52-28 hours lead. Seha gets it, tries to get it to Hayes, but Hayes gives the ball up. Here on the Owls on the break. Gutierrez pulls up. Gets it to the far side to Chamois. Chamois looks for Gutierrez again, swings it to the other side. Gutierrez puts it up, no good. Seha with a rebound. She'll give it to Flores. Flores will bring it across the timeline and start the offense. Throws it to the other side to Gray, to Hayes. Hayes puts it up, and it's good.
Nice long 2-point there by Hayes.
52-30, Owls still lead. There's Gutierrez. Gutierrez gets it to Mejia. Mejia gets it on the inside to Delgado. Delgado, it rims out, but Delgado gets a rebound. There's a fight for it. It'll be the Owls' ball off of Flores' hand.
Good hustle on the ball by Flores, making sure to fight for the rebound. We've been giving up a lot of rebounds on both sides of the court. I like that Flores was there to defend.
Mejia will take it out here on the eastern sideline. They get it to the inside. I believe that's Delgado. Yes, that's Delgado, but she misses. But Zaylin puts the ball back. Here comes the Horsehairs trying to catch him in the transition. They won't. Gray stops, gets it into Seha. Seha throws it out to Hayes. Excuse me, to Flores. Flores gets it to Etevez. Etevez will work. Does not take the screen, drives it on her own. Now it's Hayes to Seha on the outside. Seha tries to work, throws it to Etevez. Etevez for a three. Air ball, but straight to Gray. And Gray will draw the foul.
Owls are doing a good job, and they have been this entire game, of keeping close guard on the key, making the Corsairs shoot from outside where they are not as strong.
They will call that a shooting foul on, I believe that was Mejia, her first personal. Gray misses the first, and there will be changes here for the Corsairs. Evans will come in for Roberta Hayes.
O'Shea Gray has one of, if not the highest, free throw shooting percentage of her team. There she just made one for two. We need to make them all.
Mejia brings it across the timeline. 8:13 left to go in this third quarter. Mejia looks on the inside for a wide open Zaylin, who draws the foul. Foul go on Evans.
Again, that goes back, I think, to that defense under the basket.
Zaylin will get her first free throw of this trip. It's up and true.
I would like to see the Corsairs win a lot more of these defensive rebounding contests. I think that will do a lot to help create scoring opportunities on the other side of the floor that the Corsairs desperately need at this moment.
Zaylin hits the second. 56-31 Owls. Corsairs have a long way to climb if they want to get back in this one. Here's Satin. She loses the ball again. The Owls try to push it up. Shamwa brings it. She did not have numbers with her, so she held up. She'll get it to Mejia. Mejia swings it to the far side to Gutierrez. Gutierrez into Zaylin. Zaylin tries to go up and under, and it gets nothing but air. But the Owls recover. Mejia, no good. Mejia gets her own rebound. Up again, and good.
Mamasa Evans has had a difficult time this entire game with ball control. She's lost about three or four balls just simply by dribbling them.
Evria takes a long three-pointer, no good. Here comes Shamwa on the break. Gets it to Gutierrez. Gutierrez stops, guarded by Gray, throws it to Zaylin on the outside. Zaylin dribbles in, goes up and under, somehow does not get fouled, but she lost it anyway. Here's Delgado. Delgado gets it to Shamwa, to Mejia. Mejia gets it almost to the inside to Delgado, loses it off the backboard tip. Here comes Evria. All right, excuse me, Eves to Gray. Gray tries to go baseline, doesn't take it. She's guarded by Gutierrez. Now switches to Mejia. And Gray will just work the yo-yo, wait for the inbound. Pulls up herself with 13, no good. Evans gets the rebound, but throws it right to Zaylin. Here comes Citrus on the break. That's Shamwa, drives herself, goes up, and gets the foul, and one. But she is hurt, she needs assistance getting up. She's smiling now, but that must have hurt on the way down. Fast break opportunity turns into a layup, a painful one for Shamwa. She'll take her first free throw, this time touching both her feet this time.
And again, one of those very funny superstitious type things that players do when they get onto the floor. And even before, I knew a guy playing on a basketball team once who liked to eat baby chickens.
Baby chickens?
Whole baby chickens.
Whole bit.
But the little small chickens.
The little small.
Maybe they were grown chickens, but baby chickens.
And I gotta tell the folks the score. It's 61-31 Corsairs. They're trolling by 30, so baby chickens, all right?
Baby chickens. He was 6'7", could not dunk.
Okay, there's a whole lot going on in that story.
Yeah. And there's a whole lot going on in this story. You have the Corsairs who are struggling to stop a red-hot Citrus offense from the three-point line and also under the rim. And on the other side of the ball, still having problems bringing down defensive rebounds and allowing a lot of second-chance points for the Owls.
Hold up. That's all well and good, but we got to go back to the baby chickens. You don't bring up it. It's a Chekhov gun. Why would he eat baby chickens? Just superstition? Just that's
I don't know. He weighed less than I did, so I don't even know where the baby chicken went.
Did it work? Was it good?
No, it was terrible.
No, it was terrible? Oh, man.
It was terrible.
Oh, no. You can't do something that crazy and not be good.
No, it was terrible.
Well, let's get back to this one. It's 61-31 Owls. Horsehair's down by 30. 6:40 left here in the third quarter. James Powell, Claudius West, Jose Barajas on the sidelines. And San Juan has got a long way to go. Gray, who's been fighting through the flu and shin issues, gets it back, plays hot potato, I would guess, with Eves. Eves gets it back now, trying to find someone. Goes back right back to her hot potato partner in Gray. Gray drives, actually gets an open shot, and draws the foul, and she goes hard to the floor. Ooh, she landed on her knees.
She's getting up very slowly. It's important to keep in mind that she is working both injured and sick.
Now, according to the coaching staff, thanks to our crack reporting by Jose Barajas, they say her health is fine, but that's what you say.
Oh, because she's, quote, a baller.
Yes.
And that's enough for me.
That's enough, or that's at least enough for the Corsair coaching staff.
It's enough to get to the line.
It does, and she makes her first one. It's now 61-32. Owls still lead. And this is her second. It's up, and it's no good. Alice will recover that Zaylin, who loses the ball, but it falls right to Delgado's hands near Chamois.
Nice of the Corsairs to stop that fast break before it even got started.
Chamois will work at the bend of the arc. Then denies the screen, throws it out to Mejia. Mejia tries to go in, finds nothing. Corsairs in their zone. And Maria darts. Mejia with strong force, gets it into Delgado, but Satter takes the ball away.
Great defense on the perimeter, creating that stealing opportunity.
Gray does not take advantage of the numbers, though she didn't have them. Satter works on the high post. Turnaround jumper, good. 61-34, Owls. Here comes Mejia. Slight tilting of the court back towards Corsair, but it's a long way to go. Mejia drives around Satter, hits it back out to Gutierrez. Gutierrez to Zaylin. Zaylin works the inside, passes it to Delgado, off her knees. It'll be off Hayes, and Hayes is hurt. Oh, it's her knee. She's grabbing her knee now, and she is down.
Hayes going out of the game at this point. It'd be very damaging for the Corsairs, so we have to hope she's okay.
She did get up.
Gotten up without trouble.
She did get help. Satter helped her up, and it looks like maybe it was a false alarm. You don't want to see anyone grabbing at their knees at any time, especially in a basketball game.
Seen a couple of close calls in this game so far.
Yes. Now here's Delgado on the inside, rejected by Satter. Gray will push it up. The numbers are even. Gray will take it herself, drive up, under, and no good. And there will be, is it out of bounds or a foul? It'll be called a foul on the Corsairs. That was just out of bounds on the Corsairs.
Good fast break, good shot on the part of O'Shane LeGray, though. Didn't go in, but it was definitely a good fast break taken all the way.
Though it did,
of course, they've been having trouble.
It does slow down the offense of Citrus. Mejia to Gutierrez. Gutierrez comes around the bend. Gutierrez loses the ball. Does she get it in? Yes. Chamois saves on the other end of the same jump ball. Goes to the Corsairs. The next dead ball, there will be a substitution. I can't see who it is who is sitting there at the table at the moment, and she's being let in.
Coach is shaking her head on the sidelines as we speak. She looks very disappointed at the moment in the gameplay of the Corsair.
Ashkenazi comes in for Satter. Here is Gray. Gray will start the offense. The floor is now Gray, Flores, Eves, Ashkenazi, and Evans. Gray dishes it to Evans. Evans puts it up, no good, short. Now that's Brown. Brown came in for Citrus.
Another example of how we're getting beat under the rim for rebounds here, James.
Gutierrez looks to slow the offense. It looks like Citrus is starting to wind down the clock, looking to protect its players. Inside, that's Brown, and it's good. 63-34 for Owls lead. Gray will come down. She's calling for a screen. Doesn't take it from Eshkani. Eshkenazi. Now Flores. Flores swings it to Efes. Efes for three. No good, but draws a 3-point foul.
Echeves has taken quite a few threes this game. She's one of the few people who has been. She's not been shy about putting the ball up, James.
Foul will go on Brown, and that will certainly go down in head coach Lori Moore's notebook for later. You never want to give up a 3-point foul. 3-point foul. As the first shot is made. This is Moore's first year as head coach of the Owls. So far she's 9-6 and 2-0 in conference. Now Evez misses the second. This is her third. The shot's up. And off the top of the backboard, no good. Eskenazi gets it. Then Efez gets it back, pushes it out, will start the offense again. 25 on the shot clock with Gray. Gray holds the play, looking for someone on the post. Swings it around to Flores. Flores gets it in the corner, nearly taken away, out of bounds, off of Chamois' hand. They were looking for Efez there in the corner, trying to get her another three. Flores will take it in at the spot it went out, get it to Gray. 16 on the shot clock. Flores puts it up, no good. Eskenazi gets it. Eskenazi throws it out to Gray. To Efes, in the corner to Hayes. Hayes fakes, drives up. Miracle shot, no good. Ashkenazi gets it, blocked, and draws the foul.
Good drive by Hayes. Good rebound by Ashkani.
It looked like it was a foul. Now it goes to Citrus. 3:53 left here in the third quarter. That's Gutierrez. Gutierrez drives on Gray. Gives it to Chamois. Chamois gets the pick from Delgado. Gets in the corner for Meza. Meza puts it up. No. Fight for the ball on the floor. They will haul a jump ball.
Another jump ball going to Corsair's way.
Corsair's will switch again the possession arrow. Gray. Is it to Flores? Flores back to Gray. They play pass with it. Flores again inside to Hayes at the line. Hayes goes up, draws the foul, does not get the basket. That's two shots for
Hayes.
Excuse me, that's Evans.
Evans has been very aggressive in these last couple of drives to the basket here.
Now let's see if she can take advantage of the free points.
And it's going to be important as Evans shoots the first of two to keep in mind that this is where the bread is buttered for the Corsairs. It's inside. And so Hayes is going to have to drive. I'm sorry, Evans is going to have to drive. And Gray is going to have to drive.
Absolutely. We need. Absolutely. Here's her second. And it's good. 63-35, 36 now. We just changed it. Here's Mejia. Mejia starts the offense. Gets it to Brown. Brown pulls up from three. No good. Ashkenazi fights for it, and it falls to Gray. Gray on the break. Has FS next to her. Gives it to her. She drives baseline. And it's good. Took Brown out in the process. Guts the easy layup.
Here's nice him. Drive by O'Shane LeGray. With the Chavez closing out.
Here's Chamois. Gets it to Delgado. Nearly picked off by Gray. Throws it to Brown. Brown guarded by Ashkenazi. And Evans now. And Evans gets a hand on it. Falls to Delgado. And her shot does not go.
Evans here, with the power D. Evans with the rebound.
Here comes Gray. She drives it herself. Loses it. But gets it to Evans. Evans puts it up. No good. Ashkenazi puts it up again. No good. Delgado with the rebound. Ball's going the other way, but it falls right to Eves. She takes it. She's guarded by Delgado and will push it out and wait for her mates to come across. Here's Gray. Drives it. Hits it to Ashkenazi. Ashkenazi! No good. Off the back of the rim. Gray fights for a rebound but does not get it. Mejia brings it up. Looking to push. There's Chamois. Chamois has Gutierrez, but she didn't see her. Chamois did it herself, but loses the ball out of bounds to the Corsairs. Here comes some changes. Chandler will come in. Flores will come out. Mejia will come out for Citrus. And Tiffany Velarus will come in. As well as Zaylin will come back in for the Owl. She had taken a brief breather. And a reappearance of Joy Aldo. So the Citrus floor, just for clarity. It's Velarus. Velarus, Aldo, Adlau, excuse me. Zaylin and Delgado. Here's Chandler from three. No good off the bench. Out of bounds, and it will go to Citrus.
Corsairs have been forced the entire game to shoot from the outside. Chandler's shot was no different. Great defense being played on the inside by the Owls.
Here comes Villarouz around the screen. Gets it to Adlau. Adlau drives, draws a triple team that's thrown, sort of, back out. Here's Gutierrez. Gutierrez is up off the rim, but she draws the foul. Adlau will go to the line. Hayes picks up her first personal of the game. Fifth team foul. Both teams are in the double bonus for the quarter. Vanessa Zamora will come in. That's Giselle Zaha will come in. When the ref allows it after this free throw. Adlau gets her first of this half. And it's good. 64-38, Owls lead.
Right now, the Citrus Owls are hot from the perimeter. They're hot from the inside. They've struggled a little bit with fast breaks and in some transition, but overall the Corsairs are in a lot of trouble at the moment.
FS will bring it up. Zaha replaces Gray. There's Evans at the top. Plays Patty Hate with Chandler. Chandler drives, sees the lane, pulls up, and is airballed. It's thrown out. Here comes Citrus on the break. Villarruz brings it up. Almost tried to pick from Zaylin. Now here's Meza. Meza works on the far side. Gets it to Adlau. Adlau hands it off to Villarruz. Villarruz tries to drive. Runs into Hayes. Gets it out to Meza. Meza finds an open lane for Zaylin. Zaylin's up, and it's good. 66-38 Owls.
Another example of the Owls' ability to get to that board at will, pretty much.
Here's Ashkenazi to Chandler. Chandler to Eves. 24 on the shot on the game clock, 19 on the shot. Here's Eves around the bend. Gives it to almost got it. Ashkenazi almost threw it away and gets it into Hayes, out to Zetha. Zetha to Eves. Eves, pull up jumper, air ball. Out of bounds, Citrus ball.
At halftime, coach did talk about execution on the offensive side of the ball. We've seen in the last few plays the difficulty for Corsairs in finishing.
3 seconds on the clock, 2-1. The shot will not go off. Oh, it will count if it goes, and it doesn't. And here is the break. And we'll be right back with the fourth quarter right after this.
What, they have 2 minutes?
And we're back here with the final 10 minutes. Corsairs are down by a lot. 66-38 Owls. My math is not that good. Anyone who knows me knows not to trust my math. So I will let the folks at home do that. Yeah. But the Corsairs are down. If they want to mount some sort of miraculous comeback, what do they have to do?
Everything. Everything. Better execution on offense, as coach said earlier. Winning more of the defensive rebounding opportunities, and also keeping the ball. Yeah, we've just dropped the ball a couple of times here.
Yes, that has been loose with the ball and loose with the lead. Here is Villarruz. Excuse me, that's Meza. Meza, Estepan. Estepan turns around, tries to get it back to Meza, and a foul is drawn. Goes against. I believe they have the wrong number. They were calling for number 12. That is Villarruz. Villarruz will draw the foul. They get it into Setha. Setha, Whitley off the inbound. Good, and draws the foul. And now
here's that's good execution.
Now here's a chance for free throw shooting and bring them back. Setha to the line.
And Setha's been pretty good from the free throw line this game. And if she keeps playing like that, she'll draw a few more fouls that will get her there.
And that was by design. Something went off the inbound. Here's Setha's first shot. No good. Off the front of the rim. Citrus breaks the other way. Villarruz brings it up over to Zaylin. Zaylin stops, puts it up, and good. 68-40. Owls lead. Here's Gray coming the other way, trying to find something in transition. Almost loses the ball, gets it back. Throws it to Setha. Has Hayes on the outside, doesn't see her. Setha goes in herself. No good. Through a mountain of trees. She saves her own rebound, though. Gray to Eves. Eves throws it to Flores. Flores to Hayes. Hayes back to Flores to Gray. Gray and the inside to Setha. Setha, only one man, goes over her, off the backboard and in.
Nice 2-point play from the high post.
68-42, Owls lead, out of bounds, goes back to Citrus. Flores with the dive. You see their desperation starting early here in the final quarter.
I believe Setha just scored the last 5 points for the Corsairs. If she keeps playing like this, we may just be in it.
Villarruz brings the ball down, takes it herself, untouched through the lane, no good. Eves gets the rebound. She pushes it the other way. She does not have numbers, but gives it to Gray. Gray to Hayes. Hayes back to Etevez. Etevez jab steps. Once, twice, dribbles. Around Seta. Seta puts her hands up. 16 on the shot clock. Seta on the post and then bats it out. Seta inside to Hayes. Over the top. No good. Citrus with the rebound. Adlau with the rebound. And here comes Villarruz. Villarruz looking to salt this game away. 8:25 left in the final quarter. 68-42 Owls. Adlau from three near us, and it's good. That may be the dagger, folks. That's 71-42. You know what? As an old great one said, you can probably put this game in the refrigerator. The door's closed. The butter's jiggling. The jello's jiggling. The butter is hardening, and the eggs are chilling. 8:07 left here.
It's a very interesting analogy there.
Yeah, thank you, Chit Hearn, the late great. I have no problem stealing from him. But let's see how the Corsairs finish this out. Finishing as a great tell, as a tell of a great team. 71-42, Citrus goes the other way, but Flores is still fighting. She's down on the floor, as is Etevez. Jump ball goes back to Citrus in this haste, but now Santa Monica will get the ball.
Flores
get the ball on the next jump.
Flores has been very aggressive on the defensive side going after the ball, especially on inbounds plays. I think she's...
And Citrus will call a timeout here. Now, the mountain's too high, but what in these last 8 minutes, more or less, what do you want to see from the Corsairs to prove that maybe they have a little fight going forward?
I think you play. Every play, every time. If you're on defense, hands up, watch the ball. Attack, attack, attack on the offensive side of the ball. They really have to open up those passing lanes somehow. And maybe getting some better shooting opportunities on the perimeter is part of that, but that comes back down to execution of the plays that coach talked about at halftime.
All right, here we go. 7:54 left. Villarruz looks for an option. Doesn't find one. Guarded by Etevez. She drives it herself to Adlau. Adlau still doesn't find an option. Corsair is keeping it to the outside. There's Meza. Meza to Adlau. Excuse me, Zaylin in the corner, no good. Zaylin gets her own rebound. Throws it across the court, tipped. And it'll go out of bounds to Citrus. No! They will say Flores did not touch it last. They will give it to Estepan.
But Flores was right in the mix nonetheless. Nonetheless.
So here's Gray then. Throws it to Flores, back to Gray. Inside to Seta. Seta back to Gray. Gray tries to dribble, doesn't find anything. Flores nearly loses the ball, but she loses it to herself. The Gray on a dangerous pass. The Seta on a dangerous pass. The Etevez on the first safe pass of the sequence. Flores to Gray. Gray drives on the inside. Floater. No good. Owls come down with the rebound. Meza comes up. The numbers are even on the break. So she gives it to Adlau on the far side. Adlau throws it away, and it will be Santa Monica ball.
The Citrus Owls stack three people under the rim on that last offensive play for the Corsairs. Again, making it very difficult for Gray to come on the inside, so she had to take a very interesting shot there.
Gray throws it in the center at the post, turns around, throws it up. No good. Same play that came out of the half, or out of the quarter break with. Didn't work this time. Here comes Villarruz. Villarruz waits. Time taken away from the Corsairs' hands. To Villarruz again for three. Around, around, and in. Gray on the push, trying to catch him in transition. Goes to the far side, drives, open lane up, and good. A little bit of speed does them well. Now Citrus will slow it down. 6:20 left to go. That's Meza with the ball. Throws it to Villarruz, who saw it only at the last second, who drives herself. No good. Was hit in the arm, but no foul. Here's Hayes, who fights for the rebound, and it'll be out of bounds off of Flores. As Estepan forced her to drop the ball off her leg.
Very, very kind of a messy play there. But again, Citrus puts a lot of pressure on the Corsairs near the basket, and you can see where it's making it very difficult to score.
Villarruz puts it in right off the rebound, inbound, 78-44, Owls lead. Excuse me, 76. Stays at 76. Okay, here's Chandler to Gray, into Seta, to Chandler. Chandler drives, stops, gives it to Seta. Seta drives, and is called for traveling. I can't tell you what number that is.
I believe that's four, Jay.
That's four traveling. Well, it's the unofficial score, but I'll use it. Four travelings on Seta this evening. Here's Villarruz. 5:45 left to go. Villarruz to Gutierrez. Gutierrez drives herself, guarded by Hayes. Hayes drives her into past the corner to Esteban. Esteban works in the middle. In a mountain, in a forest of trees, gets it out to Zaylin. Zaylin loses it on the baseline. Horsehair ball. Gray got the tip on her.
Great defense inside by the Corsairs. They made the Owls really fight for it, and great with the hands.
Here's Gutierrez, almost gets knocked over by Hayes. Here's Villarruz, drives the middle, sends it out to Matna. Matna gets her first points of the evening. The Owls bench goes nuts. Here's Gray, trying to find them in celebration. Finds nothing to Efes from way outside, no good. Hayes fights for the rebound. Corsairs will get the ball on the jump.
It's going to be very important for the Corsairs to take more high percentage shots. Again, the defense of the Citrus Owls is making those high percentage shots very difficult to make, to have in the first place. But we have to get in position, and then we have to make the buckets when we do.
Chandler hurls it to Hayes. Hayes short, but draws the foul. Hayes will get two free throws here. That is the Owls' third team foul of this quarter. One more, the Horsehairs will be in the single bonus, two more in the double. Hayes' first is no good. 5:04 left to play here. Couple of changes here for Citrus. First one, Zaylin will go out for Adela, or Adela will come in for Zaylin. And then, Estepan will go out for Magna. Hayes' second is good. And then another change, Gutierrez will come out as well. Villarruz will bring it out. She works on Flores, gets it to the far side to Adlau. Adlau nails the three again.
And once again, the Owls are on their feet. Meanwhile, the bench is kind of somber on the Corsair side.
All right, Hayes.
Not a lot of energy.
Hayes in the corner, jab stitch, gets it out to Chandler. Chandler tries to sets up the screen from Sethas and denies it. Reorganizes the offense, gives it to Flores. The Sethas passes tip. Chandler is able to save it. Nearly stepped out on the sidelines. There's Flores to Efes. Efes again for three. No. And then that will be Rosas coming in. She replaced Gutierrez at the last change. She fights. And now the Horsehairs are putting on the press. They almost take away the ball. And it's a jump ball. It'll stay with Citrus.
Mamasa Seka has been a serious factor in the Corsairs' improvement in defense in this second quarter. Didn't do quite the same things in the first quarter, but she seems to be more aware. She's executing on defense a whole lot better than she did the first two quarters of the game.
Villarruz will start again.
Creating big plays.
Corsair is trying to keep the pressure up, hoping for something, but she breaks it. Easy layup is missed. Flat missed and an air ball. But the Citrus Owls get it back. Shot is up. Adlau, no good, but she draws the foul, and the Citrus bench was ready to explode if that had gone in.
Oh, yes. It's been a party. On the Citrus side of the Citrus side of the ball, both on the court and off the court.
Flores takes the foul. It is her third personal. Adler to the line. First is good.
This is a game that the Corsairs let get away from them very early, losing the battle, the 3-point battle, losing the rebounding battle. And it's showing right now in the score.
The second free throw was good. Here's Chandler. Gray's on the bench, hoping to save her. Center goes up, draws the foul, and will go to the line.
Seca's been a fixture at that line in the second half of this game, Jen.
She has, but now is the time she needs to convert. This is where she can show Hope Strong going forward that she is worthy of she's worthy of staying on the first team. And going into her sophomore year, she's worthy of staying on the team for her sophomore year. She missed the first one, and it's always in garbage time that you really find the measure of teams. This is certainly garbage time. It's 83-46 Owls. Here comes Citrus down the floor. Matt Nutt goes up, and it's good.
Flores was very slow to get up on that last defensive play.
She was. It's 85-46 now. And Flores did look hurt.
She looks hurt.
They may want to consider taking her out, especially with 3:30 left in the game.
And about a 30-point deficit.
31, but again, like I said earlier, don't trust my math. Horsairs will retain the ball. You have to fetch it from the practice court.
But on the high side of things, I'm liking the fight in Gray and Seca. We just turned the ball over on a
travel. So Murphy's Law, right? You call their name and they turn it over. Here's Villaruz. Villaruz will bring it up, guarded by Flores. Villaruz drives the lane, gets it out to Magna. Magna saves it, turns it around to Villaruz again. To Adlau. Adlau looks, drives it herself against Hayes. Cuts the middle, draws two. And it's out of bounds, off of Estepan's hands for Sarah Ball.
Hayes was very aggressive on the defense. She was right in their face. And she's a big player on the team. That's where she needs to be.
Here's Hayes on the inside. No good. Short. Ball goes up and to Citrus.
It was also Hayes on that last drive to the basket as well.
So here's Villaruz. Again, guarded by Flores. They're staying with that matchup. Villaruz pulls out. Gives it to Matna. Matna to Adlau. Adlau. Now guarded by Aves. Here's Rosas. Guarded by Seca. Loses the ball off her foot, but keeps it. I wouldn't call that exactly a pass, but that's Villaruz. Goes all the way up, doesn't get it. Here comes the Horsairs on the break. That's Seca alone. Up and good. 85-48. Owls lead. 2:20 left to play. Here's Estepan. That's the Panda Villaruz. Will just continue to wind the clock down. She'll drive and give it to Rosas. Rosas from downtown, no. Aves. Rosas wanted to take that shot, would have taken that shot from Pearl Street if she could. There's Chandler. Gives it to Hayes. Hayes on the inside. It's blocked. But in the process of the block, she draws the foul and will go to the line for two.
I can't help but wish that the Corsairs were able to make more of these drives earlier in the game when the score was just a bit closer.
Just under 2 minutes
to go. But it's good to see now because it's very easy for players to get discouraged. You can see that there's not too much energy over on the bench, but on the floor, the Corsairs still seem to be putting up a fight. There's definitely a lot to learn from this game, but playing through to the end is one of those things that good players do. So I definitely like what I'm seeing, and I'm sure that the improvements will come, especially most of these players are freshmen. So the next year may be great for them.
Well, here's that fight that you saw. Flores is in the corner. The Horsairs still have three timeouts, and it will hit the ball.
And Flores has found herself in quite a few of these scuffles for the ball down on the floor. Lots of hustle from her. She has a lot of tenacity, and I'm loving what I see from her.
Chandler's floater is no good, but the rebound's from Seca. Seca puts it up, and we'll get the ball to fall, and the foul. 85-49 with a free throw. Excuse me, 85-51 with a free throw coming.
You talked earlier about following through for Seca. That was one of those plays. She followed through all the way and drew the foul, threw the and one for the trouble.
But she does not convert on the and one. Here's Rosas, who gives it to Villaruz, who ball stripped by Flores. That's a second strip in a row. And will they haul that a foul? The ball will stay with the Horsairs. And the officials will haul a foul on Villaruz.
Flores once again finds herself on the ground fighting for the ball. You definitely want players like that on your team, no matter what the score is. You want players who are willing to get down there and get it every play. And Flores has been doing it all game.
Absolutely, and she converts on the first of two. And that's the second series in a row that she's gotten on the floor to try to snip the ball.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, the second time she's drawn a foul. Horsairs are now in the double bonus. Second free throw is good. 85-53 now. with just 1:30 left to go in the game. Here's Villarruz. Again, trying to wind that clock, take as much of the shot clock as possible. It's at 20 now. Villarruz goes behind the back, drives, pulls up, and is blocked by Setha. Setha will throw it out for the break. Hands up defense from the Owls, and it'll go out of bounds to the Horsairs.
Again, Seka has been a factor in this second half of the game. Yes, she's missed some shots. You still see some trouble handling the ball, but when it comes to the defense, she's doing pretty well this half.
Long two from the corner from Hayes is no good, but Seka and Hayes fight the ball, but the foul will likely go to Seka. Excuse me, it will go
Hayes.
I should not try to be an Oracle. I should probably not play the Powerball. But there's Flores with a steal underneath. No good on the steal opportunity. Here comes Rosas. Bodied. But it gets to Villarruz. Villarruz with a help on the wing. No good. Villarruz goes up. Fights for own rebound, but Hayes comes up with it. There's Flores now. Gives it to Efez. Efez crosses over. Drives the middle. Gives it out to Seha, who swings it to Hayes. Two. No good. Hayes gets her own rebound. Looks for Seha on the outside. She drives it in. Gives it to Hayes. To Flores. To Chandler. Chandler drives. Sends it out to Seha. Seha for three. Good! With 28 seconds left to go, it is now 85-56 Owls. Now here comes Esteba. Esteba gives it to Villarruz. Shot clock is off now. Owls can run down the clock as far, but they will take one last shot. No good. Hayes comes down with the rebound. Flores to Chandler. 9, 8, 7. They get it to nobody. It was intended for Hayes. It went to no one with just 3/10 of a second
little bit
over
hasty.
Five left.
A little bit hasty on the pass. Not quite placing the ball where it should have been. Could have been a little more inside.
The last sentence will wind down here. And that's it. The final score here, Citrus College Owls 85, Santa Monica College Horsairs 56. And let's go down to the sidelines with Jose Barajas.
We're here with Citrus head coach. Coach, tell me about this win.
It was a great team win. We did what we needed to do as a team. We played together, both ends of the floor, offensively and defensively, made a lot of shots. It was a good effort.
You guys seemed like you had something going at the three-point line. You want to speak about that?
That's our team. We have a lot of shooters. We have a lot of playmakers. I think us getting those open shots had a lot to do with our post players, making easy baskets in the paint, and then with them helping in the paint, we were getting open shots.
How does a victory like this help the team going forward?
It's a good victory. It was one that we needed under our belt to get us going for the Saturday that's coming up against Canyons. And I think it was just overall team win.
Do you feel you're ready for Saturday?
I think so. We have a couple days to practice and get ready, and we'll just go from there.
Thank you very much, Coach. Back to you.
This is a tough loss for the Horsairs. What can they learn from this?
Well, they can learn a few things, James. First of all, there were problems with the offensive, not play calling, but execution of plays. It wasn't that the Citrus Isles had the best defense on the planet. What it was is that we missed a lot of shots. We didn't execute a lot of the pass plays well. Also, rebounding was not so great. That can use improvement. And also, too, the defense of the perimeter shot. Can be looked at after this game because the Citrus Owls were unusually hot from the line, but when they were, there wasn't much that the Corsairs were able to do about it. Also, a little bit more awareness with the ball for certain players. There were a few bad travel calls, kind of unnecessary when there was no pressure. And then there were also just dropped balls that just rolled across the court. A lot of little things to work on, but the team is young. The team is hungry. They have next year to get it right.
That is true. And that's it for us, for James Powell, Claudius West, and Jose Barajas. Thank you.